Hi guys, my name is Jorge again here with Surf's Electronics, and today I would like to explain to you how to install your brand new Surf's LED Retrofit Kit. As you know, this LED Retrofit Kit will enable you to replace your old fluorescent lights with new and high quality LED lighting. Before doing anything, make sure that you read the Retrofit Kit's instruction manual and the datasheet. And if necessary, seek assistance from a licensed electrician when handling AC power lines. Now you're gonna want to start by disconnecting the main power from the circuit box by turning off the switch to the room or the luminaires that you'll be working on. Now wait just a few seconds to allow the lights to cool down, and then open your 2x4 fluorescent fixture and remove the four fluorescent lamps. Remember that these lamps are made to fit, so you're gonna need to move them diagonally a little bit to be able to remove them. Once you remove the lamps, there should be a cover in the middle of the troffer that it's gonna be covering the ballast and protecting them. Remove this cover by pinching on the edges in each end and in the middle. Once that you remove the cover, you have to remove it the same way as the lamps, by moving it diagonally. Now that you've uncovered the ballast, you're gonna cut first the black wire, then the white wire, and finally all the yellow wires, which are the socket wires. Since you have the power disconnected from the main circuit box, you should not worry about which wire to cut first, because there's really no voltage coming from the AC mainline at this point. After removing the ballast, you can remove the tombstones, which are basically the connectors to the tubes, by unscrewing them from the troffer. You might want to save these components in case you want to reinstall your fluorescent lights in the future. Now, after removing your old fluorescent light system, you're gonna want to start by cleaning the troffer with a glass cleaner like Windex, and then rubbing alcohol to remove any dirt, adhesives, or grease left by the old fluorescent lights. This step is important because an unclean or dirty troffer will prevent the LED strips and power supply from adhering correctly, and they will lose adhesion due to the heat with time. Okay, now connect your meanwhile power supply AC input to the main AC line using wire nuts, and then secure them with electrical tape. The white wire is hot and the black wire is neutral. Once you connect the power supply, remove the backing film from the 3M red adhesive tape and secure it to the troffer. Before connecting the LEDs, turn on the main breaker switch briefly to be sure that you have 12 volts DC on the output. Now, you're gonna install the LED strips. You're gonna want to do one by one and start by peeling the backing film from the adhesive and securing them to the troffer. You're gonna want to take them like this in the following picture. As you can see, the main power supply should be right in the middle and it should be close enough so the wires can reach to the AC mainline, and close enough so the other DC output wires can connect to the strips. And also the strips should be evenly distanced from each other. Now install the old ballast cover to protect them and hide the power supply and wires. After putting the LED strips and the cover, you might want to put some RTV clear silicone in key points of the strip to help them secure better. You can also use it to hide wires or secure them, or whatever kind of securement that you want to use. This step is not really necessary, but it's highly recommended and helpful because it will protect your strips from detaching in the long run. Now connect the wire leads from the power supply to the LED strips and test the LEDs. To test the LEDs, you have to once again turn on the main breaker switch from the circuit box and then turn on your lights. Once you're happy with the lights, close the fixture carefully. Okay, now for some troubleshooting. If your LED retrofit ever turns off, check to see that your wires are properly connected and your power supply is also properly connected to the AC line. If you ever see a strip hanging, this is due to not properly securing them, and you'll need to add some silicone or reattach some adhesive tape. Well guys, I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, make sure you comment down below. Remember to like and to subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.